Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. There is a new comet in the sky that you may have seen in the media, either online or on some other form of news. Then that is being called the Green Comet, that only comes around once every 50,000 years or so, and that you may only ever see a green comet once. I've already seen a green comet before, so I don't know if that's really true, but I will show you how to find it and how it will look from your exact location. So if you already have Stellarium, which I hope you've downloaded that from stellarium.org, as many of my subscribers already have, and by the way, if you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, and I hope you like this video too, I will show you how to upload a specific comet into Stellarium, because it is not an intuitive process. I've already done a video on this before, but I'll show you how to do it specifically for this one, since it's been a while since I did that. So we're going to go to the configuration window. Plugins, and then under Solar System Editor, we want to configure that. And then we're going to go to the Solar System tab there. And you'll notice that there's a bunch of comets already in there. Some of them are some pretty well-known ones, like Halley's Comet is right there. But the one that we want, which is C2022 E3, is not in there. We can scroll through it, but it's not there. There's some 2014, 2019s, but the one that we want is not there. So how do we get that? Well, we want to import orbital elements in MPC format. So we do that. Right up here, it says asteroids or comets. You want to click on comets for sure. And then for the bookmark, the one that I use is MPC's list of observable comets. It's just the easiest one for me to be able to find the comet that I'm looking for. And then we want to get the orbital element. So we'll click on that, and it's going to open up this other window. And we got to scroll down, a ways, keep going. There's a lot of them. There's a lot of comets. We're in the 2022s, just there. And there it is. So we want Comet C2022 E3 ZTF. That ZTF stands for the Zwicky Transient Facility. They were the facility that actually discovered this particular comet. A lot of other comets that have been fairly bright in the news over the last couple of years have been NEOWISE comets. You can see C2022F2 was a NEOWISE comet, but we want this one, which is a ZTF. So we're going to click on that and then click Add Objects. And then we go ahead and we close that. And when we zoom in to the north, there it is. I knew approximately where it was going to be at, so I already had myself facing towards the north. And then when we click on the comet itself, you can actually zoom in a little bit more using your mouse wheel if you'd like, so you can actually see where the comet is at. We can see that the magnitude is supposed to be around 6.16. Stellarium really does kind of estimate this, sometimes not all that well. We have been told that this comet was supposed to be naked eye. Some people say comets are like cats. They have tails and do what they want. I look at it more like comets are more like customer service, have very low expectations for them, and if things exceed your expectations, be happy. That seems to be the better one for me. And in this case, this comet is likely to not exceed our expectations, because as we go forward in time, actually, I'm going to show you something else. See how there's all this information here? That's way more information than we actually need. I usually just want the magnitude. You can keep all that up there if you want, but to me, it gets very distracting. So I go into the configuration window under information, and I just do short. And then that gives me the magnitude. And that's all I really want. It also gives the right ascension and declination, which is sometimes helpful if you want to do something like using a go-to mount and be able to put in the right ascension and declination coordinates. That way it'll go directly to the comet once you've done your polar alignment or your two or three star alignment. So when we close that, that's where the comet is at. If I bring up a few more stars here in Stellarium. There we go. Labels and markers. Been a while since I did that. So when we zoom in, we can see that we're close to this star in Draco, which is a third magnitude star. For most of you, you should be able to see that even from suburban skies. This star is a little brighter than that at 2.7. But what's going to happen is this particular comet is going to go right by Polaris. It also goes by Kochab. So let's watch it over the next few days. We can watch how it goes right up here. Boom. So there it's near Kochab on the 26th and 27th. Not too far away from that. If you've also downloaded this measuring tool like I have on here, that's not a standard thing on Stellarium. It is a good thing to add, though. You can find that in the configuration as well. We're only 4 degrees away from it on the 26th for me. On the 27th, it's about the same, about 4 or 5 degrees away, maybe. Oh, a little less than that, about 3 degrees. So that would be a good time if you have clear skies in. I have had ridiculously cloudy skies for what seems like weeks and weeks and weeks on end. So I've not even had a chance to look for this comet. You'll also notice that the magnitude of the comet itself, when I take off the measuring tool there, we're still only at 5.62. That's technically naked eye, but you're really going to need binoculars. I live under Bortle 4 skies, which are fairly dark, and I'm sure I would have a lot of difficulty seeing a spread out magnitude 5.6 object without using binoculars. Naked eye would be very difficult. And even when we go forward in time at its closest point to us, which is right around the 30th of December and 1st of February, it's kind of near Polaris. It's about 10 degrees away there. So it's a little ways away. That's a little further to go. 10 degrees is your fist held at arm's length, that distance all the way across. So you can measure kind of out that distance off towards the east. You might be able to find it a little easier that way. But we're still only at magnitude 5.4. That's not that bright. Most people from any urban area and most suburban areas are going to have difficulty seeing any fifth magnitude objects, period. Fourth magnitude, I was always excited to see when I was in a Bortle 5 area. And that was, people loved to come to my house because I had darker skies than they did. So I'm in Bortle 4, which is even darker now. I can see magnitude 5 and sometimes 6 stars without any issue. But again, this is not a pinpoint object. This is spread out. So seeing that is going to be pretty challenging. Binoculars definitely is the way to go. You don't have a lot of bright stars to go by once it's up by Polaris either, because these are, these are all like fifth magnitude stars right in here. That's not helpful. I suppose the one thing that you can try to do is wait for it to get up by Capella, because it's going to go straight up. And as it does, I back up. I want to actually be able to see the comet. There we go. Pop right on it. You'll see right around the 4th, and especially the 5th for me anyway, it's only about a degree away from Capella. So Capella is a nice bright first magnitude star. That makes it easy to find. I suppose the other thing you could do is somewhere in between there, between those times, you can just say, all right, well, I know the comet is between Polaris and Capella. Polaris is a second magnitude star. You can see that from most anywhere. Capella's first magnitude, that's easy to see from just about any location. So you can kind of estimate where your distance is using that distance tool. And say, okay, well, on the 2nd, it's going to be about 25 degrees from Polaris, kind of in the direction of Capella. 25 degrees, you could measure kind of like this, holding your thumb and your pinky out at arm's length and be able to find the comet. So that's how to download it, how to find it. I would say definitely use binoculars to see it at minimum, or at least locate it first. It may look a little green, more likely to look green in photographs, just because the photographs capture light over a longer period of time when we use a longer exposure, and your eyes may not pick up that green color, which is due to I believe diatomic carbon, as it's kind of sloughed off by sunlight, the solar wind hitting those and causing it to glow in green. And if you want to, you can use a telescope if you have a shorter focal length. You might be able to get a nice field of view with a shorter focal length eyepiece. If you just have a longer telescope like this one, which is an F-15 and has still just use a long focal length eyepiece that you can and see what you can spot. The larger your aperture, the more light you gather, the more you might be able to see. That's going to be the best way to go. So that will be the way that you can try to see Comet C 2022 E3 ZTF. in the night sky. Hopefully, if your clouds clear for you, like I hope they clear for me, or if they are clear for you, great. Share some pictures with me on Twitter. I'd love to see them, and we'll see what we might all be able to find of this once-in-a-lifetime, 50,000 years around the sun, comet that may or may not be green. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.